From a shrimp that packs a devastating punch, to strange creatures that dwell in the sand, here are 10 of the world's creepiest crustaceans. Before we begin, be sure to subscribe to They Will Kill You. Hit the like button and request any topics you'd like to learn about in the comments section below. Number 10, skeleton shrimp. The skeleton shrimp, or the ghost shrimp, is known for its thread-like, slender, semi-transparent body. Using its short, spiky legs, the skeleton shrimp anchors itself to coral, sponges, and seaweed, where it lies in ambush of prey, remaining motionless for long periods of time. Additionally, it assumes an angular pose in order to resemble the fronds among which they live. Skeleton shrimps are omnivorous, feeding on smaller amphipods and crustacean larvae, using its claw-like nathopods to snatch smaller invertebrates. Similar to the praying mantis, female skeleton shrimps inject males with venom and consume them shortly after mating. Number 9. Masked crab. The masked crab, also known as the helmet crab, is a burrowing crab whose carapace can grow up to 1.6 inches long. Its name was inspired by the patterns on its carapace that resemble a human face. The masked crab lives buried in sandy substrates, feeding on invertebrates. The two elongated antennae at the head end of its carapace form a breathing tube that allows oxygenated water down into the substrate. Masked crabs are usually found in the North Atlantic and North Sea, from Portugal to Norway, and also in the Mediterranean Sea. Number 8. Remipedes. Remipedes are a species of crustaceans that resemble centipedes. They have long, segmented bodies with dozens of paddling limbs, and they possess a large set of fangs which inject a combination of digestive enzymes and venom into their prey. A remipede grows up to 1.6 inches long, but it lacks eyes and pigmentation, basically looking like something out of a horror movie. Remipedes are the only known venomous crustaceans. Fortunately, they live in the darkest areas of the deep underground water. They are also the arthropods that are most closely related to insects. Number 7. Pistol shrimp. The pistol shrimp, or alpheid shrimp, is a very noisy species of crustaceans whose snapping sounds can even interfere with sonar and underwater communication. Its name was inspired by its large claw that can be on either arm of the body and has a pistol-like feature made of two parts. The upper part of the claw is pulled backward into a right-angled position by a joint. When released, it snaps into the lower part of the claw, emitting a powerful wave of bubbles capable of paralyzing or killing small fish and even breaking small glass jars. Interestingly enough, the pistol shrimp's snapping sound competes with noises made by much larger animals, such as the sperm whale. When it snaps shut, its claw is capable of creating a cavitation bubble that generates acoustic pressures and sounds reaching 218 decibels. Number 6. Pram bug. The pram bug is a species of deep sea crustaceans found throughout the world's oceans except for the polar region. Its body is semi-transparent and is often compared to the creatures of the movie Alien due to its elongated head, but also its parasitoid lifestyle. The female pram bug will attack a planktonic tunicate called salp. Using its mouth and claws, the pram bug will eat the salp and hollow out its gelatinous shell in order to enter it and lay its eggs inside. As the larvae develop, the pram bug propels the shell through the water and regularly pulls prey inside the body, tearing it apart in order to provide the larvae with fresh food. Number 5. Arrow crab. The arrow crab is a marine crab with a triangular, upward-orientated body and spider-like legs. While its body is drawn out into a long point with serrated edges that can reach 2.4 inches in length, its legs are thin and can grow up to 3.9 inches. Arrow crabs are aggressive scavengers that feed on small feather duster worms and other coral reef invertebrates. They're used for controlling bristleworm populations in reef aquariums, but have also been known for killing shrimp or slow-swimming fish. Their unusual appearance is what makes them creepy, as they don't pose a threat to us. Number 4. Sacculina. Sacculina is a parasitic crustacean known for injecting itself into the body of a host crab and taking over its body. Sacculinas live in marine environments, and their primary host is the green crab, native to the eastern Atlantic Ocean. Its body can be divided into two parts. The first, called externa, is a bulbous reproductive organ that sticks out of the abdomen of the host. The other part, called interna, is composed of root-like dendrils that wrap themselves around the host's organs and are located inside its body. Male Sacculina and female Sacculina have different life cycles. The female larva usually finds a crab and walks on it in search of a joint. It then injects its soft body into the crab, shedding its shell and molting into a form called a chondrogon. After the Sacculina grows into the crab's body, the crab becomes unable to molt, loses nutrition, and its overall growth is impaired. Furthermore, if a female Sacculina infests a male crab, it will interfere with its hormonal balance, sterilizing it and manipulating it to act like a female. The crab's energy is no longer expended on reproduction, and it develops a nurturing behavior towards the Sacculina. However, the male Sacculina looks for an adult female parasite on the underside of a crab. When it finds its female, it will implant itself into the female's body and start fertilizing her eggs. As the crab has been sterilized, it will then care for the Sacculina eggs as if they were its own. There are currently more than 100 species of Sacculina recognized. Number 3. Mantis shrimp. Mantis shrimp, or stomatopods, are marine crustaceans that grow from around 4 to 15 inches. The largest one ever caught measured 18 inches and was found in the Indian River near Fort Pierce, Florida. Some species have sharp forelimbs used to capture prey, while others have specialized calcified clubs that can strike with great power. They're divided into spearers and smashers based on the tactic used to kill prey. They've one of the most elaborate visual systems ever discovered. The eyes of mantis shrimps carry 16 types of color receptive cones and can see ultraviolet and polarized light. Furthermore, they've trinocular vision, being able to see objects using one of the three different parts of their eyes. Mantis shrimps are among the most important predators in many shallow tropical and subtropical waters. Both smashers and spearers strike by rapidly unfolding and swinging their raptorial claws at the prey. Their attack is so quick that it happens 50 times faster than the blink of an eye. They strike with a velocity of 51 miles per hour, and their punch has the power of a 22 caliber bullet. They can inflict serious damage on victims, significantly greater in size, and smashers are known for their ability of breaking the glass of an aquarium with their strong punches. Mantis shrimp are often kept in private aquariums. Number 2. Japanese spider crab. The Japanese spider crab is a species of marine crab that has the largest leg span of any arthropod, reaching up to 18 feet from claw to claw. The body can grow to a size of 16 inches in carapace width and can weigh up to 42 pounds. Its legs are covered in armored exoskeletons, which help protect them from larger predators. It uses its carapace as camouflage as its bumpy surface blends into the rocky ocean floor. Living in the waters around Japan and neighboring parts of the Pacific Ocean, it's considered a delicacy. Known to the Japanese for the serious injuries it can cause with its strong claws, even though Japanese spider crabs are some of the creepiest crustaceans because of their size and eerie resemblance to spiders, they don't really pose a threat to us. They dwell around vents and caves at depths of 160 to 2,000 feet and feed on plant matter, mollusks, and other crustaceans. Number 1. Sand fleas. Sand flea, also known as sand hopper, is the common name often given to crustaceans that live on sand beaches near the high tide mark. They typically remain buried in the sand during daytime and emerge at night to forage for food. Their hopping ability is the only resemblance they share to fleas, as they aren't known to bite people. Sand fleas belong to the Talitridae amphipod family and usually feed on organic debris. The common sand flea grows up to 0.4 inches long and is rather hard to spot due to its dark brown or grey coloration and bluish tail. It's found on the eastern Atlantic coast of the Americas from Greenland to Uruguay and on the coast of Europe. Although they're definitely creepy, these crustaceans aren't actually dangerous to humans. The true sand flea that you should definitely steer clear of is an insect known as the chigo flea. This parasitic insect, which only grows up to 0.03 inches in length, is found in Central and South America and Africa. It's known to burrow into mammalian skin, including humans, to feed and lay eggs and may cause a painful infection.